All right, thank you very much. We're very close to the track where next year the first high-speed testing is going to be done by the Bloodhound. With me is a man known as the second fastest man in the world. In 1983, in thrust two, he sets a new world land speed record at 633 miles per hour, or just over 1,000 kilometers per hour. Richard Noble. That record has subsequently been broken by an Andy Green, who Richard brought into the Bloodhound Project. Richard himself is the project director of the Bloodhound Project. Welcome to Morning Live.
Hey, well, I'm really glad to be here. It's nice to be back in South Africa again.
You said that the bug of speed bit you when you were just 5 years old and you haven't been able to let up. Why would you want to set the record at 1,000 miles per hour? And the idea behind Bloodhound?
Yeah. Well, it's a huge, turned itself into a huge education project. And all over the world, there is a real big problem in terms of recruiting of scientists and engineers and getting the kids excited about all this. And so basically, we've turned the project into a large educational program. And for instance, in England, we've got over 5,000 schools studying it now. But here, the great thing about here is that from when we start running the car next year at Hexteen Pan, we'll be out downloading from the car 300 data channels of all the information. So all the schools can study it in huge detail.
And that data is something that's so important. I mean, that's why you guys have been spending the last 24 hours busy testing the communication capacities of the radio as well as the data connections to the main control room.
This is exactly this. This is we're very grateful for the MTN sponsorship, which has enabled us to take place. They put up four huge masts here, which enable us to get the data from the car directly down to Uppington and then, of course, into the global internet. So it's very important that we get all this absolutely right. So this is what's happening here at the moment.
All right, so behind us we've got an L39 Albatross jet. Yeah. We've got a preview of the brand new Jaguar, something that you drove in yesterday. Yeah. And we've got another Jaguar, an XFS, all kinds of and machinery that we're going to be seeing a little bit later on. But what exactly are they going to be doing today?
Well, the idea is basically we want to output the signals from both the aeroplane, which is, of course, travels faster than the car, and also from the cars as well. So we're getting both the high level and also the low level. That's very, very important, and we need to be sure that we can get that signal out at these sort of speeds. The jet plane, of course, doesn't go all that fast compared with the car. The car will go twice as fast as the jet plane, but it's as near as we can get at the moment.
I'm very, very interested. What actually happens to a driver's body when you're going at those kinds of speeds? And what is just a taste of what Andy's going to be experiencing when he tries this, you know, world record attempt? What exactly is his body going to be going through?
It's quite interesting, actually, because basically the acceleration is around about 2G acceleration and then 3G deceleration. Neither of those are particularly serious, except, of course, when you're going from the transition from through the measured mile at 3.6 seconds and then into the violent deceleration. That's when it's got to be tough. And, of course, he's got to be absolutely on the spot, otherwise he's going to end up in Namibia.
And because it was Andy that broke your previous record, you never thought that I want to create this Bloodhound and myself get into the vehicle?
Oh, yes. Well, I mean, you know, this is all part of it. It is... Doing a land speed record project is about the most exciting thing you can do on God's earth. I mean, you really can, because the engineering that goes into it, the innovation, the creativity, the huge effort to raise the money and put it all together, it's a huge and very, very stimulating program.
Bloodhound is still busy being put all together. How far are you guys? And are you quite happy with the progress so far?
Yeah, we're doing okay now. It's taking much, much longer than we thought to actually put all this together. But basically where we are now is we're over 50% through the build of the car, and we're going to roll it out from its workshop in July, and we're going to do testing in UK, and we're going to move it straight out here, and we're going to be here in September.
Now, the Bloodhound is a specially designed vehicle. It is a supersonic car. It's got three different types of engine. It's got a Formula One Cosworth engine. It's got a jet engine. It's got a rocket engine. I feel like myself, I've learned something extraordinary over the last 2 days about engineering, and they really do live up to their name, that the Bloodhound Project really is an engineering adventure. We're going to be chatting to you a little bit later on after you've done the testing. Thank you very much, Richard. Richard Noble.
Thank you.
All right, Richard Noble is going to be getting into one of the vehicles that is going to be taking part in this morning's testing. And the big thing is that they're testing communication ahead of the high-speed testing when the Bloodhound reaches the Northern Cape for the very first time next year. Let's go back to the studio.